Yo, what is up, guys? It's Kick Center here. Post my first video in a while. The reason I really haven't been posting is because I just didn't have the time to do it. But now I'm trying like this YouTube capture thing. So it'll be a lot easier to upload than going to my computer and editing everything. So sorry if the videos aren't, I guess it's cool with all the editing and stuff. But hopefully you guys still stick around and enjoy the content. But this video is going to be my top 5 pickups in 2015. Today is Christmas Day for me. I just got back from my grandparents, so I just decided to make a video because I'm bored, and all I really got for Christmas was clothes, so there's not a point of doing a Christmas pickup. But actually, one of these shoes in here is actually a partial Christmas present. So let's get into the top 5 pickups of 2015. Alright guys, so for the first shoe, I picked these up for $130 on an app called Mercari. I don't know if any of you guys use it, but I picked these up. I wore them probably 5 times since then. I think it was a really good deal for $130. I know these are dropping in price a lot. Here, just trying to get these in the shot. I also bought the socks to match them, the LeBron, like, Nike Elite socks, pretty cool. But, I thought that was a pretty good steal for what I got those for. Next shoe, this was the shoe that was a partial Christmas present. It is the, maroon 6s, that Nike Air. All you guys probably seen this already. I wore these once. There's kind of yellowing already, which I'm kind of pissed about, because if I'm paying $220 for a shoe, $230 plus tax, I don't want them to yellow the first time when I wear them in 2 hours. Like, that's complete BS. I hate that Nike's like doing that now. My third shoe that I picked up this year was the Black Cement 3 from 2006. This is a 2006 pair. I got these for I got the maroon 6s for retail. I got these for $150. The only thing wrong with them was I just had to repaint the midsole, which I think I did a pretty good job on, in my opinion. And then there's the scuff right there on the tongue. Hopefully you can see that. But that was about it for flaws on the shoe. And OG everything. All of these shoes in here have OG box, at least. But yeah, that's about it. These last two shoes, number 1 and 2, I did not know what to put at number 1, but I'm just going to show you these right here. These are the Jordan 11 Breads, Bread 11. I'm sure you've all seen these before. Sure, all you're probably thinking they're fake, but they're not fake. It's just the 23 was scratched off. This is from the Countdown Pack. Oh, probably can't see the box, but Countdown Pack box. Came with the Taxi 12s. Everyone went nuts over this pack because the Taxi 12s and the Bread 11s are like both like really desired shoes. Usually in Countdown packs, there would be like one good shoe and one bad. But this pack, everyone went nuts over it. The flaw is the 23, obviously, but I ordered some, like, you can iron on like a 23. I ordered some, they're in the mail, and they should be coming pretty soon. But it's taken a while because, like, Christmas and stuff. Only flaws was the 23, and there's, like, a pretty big chunk of scuff right there, out of there. But, the back, the leather is not creased, like, that much at all. So I was really happy with that pickup. I got them for $140, which is a really good price for Bread 11s. And then this is my number 1/2. I didn't know what to put at number 1 and 2. But the Jordan 11 7210s, these are still completely dead stock. I do not know when I'm gonna wear these. Probably sometime next year, to be honest. Like, probably in like the summer. I'm not gonna wear these to school because I live in Wisconsin, and when it's snowing and raining and stuff, your shoes just yellow like 10 times faster. I'm sure you've all seen reviews on these, so I don't really need to show you the box or anything too much. But the leather in this shoe, this shoe is amazing. It's just such a clean shoe. I saw pictures of the 7210s, like, that were already yellowed. like before it even got up to retail stores. Which that sucks if you got a pair that was pre-yellowed. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's about it for my top 5 pickups. And then I also got this Supreme sweatshirt. I just saw a video to Infinite Kicks. Shout out to you. You and Sports Heat both inspired me to start doing YouTube again. I took a long break because of school and everything, but I'm trying this YouTube capture thing. It won't be as good quality, but at least you guys are actually getting something. But I got the Supreme sweatshirt. I'm actually going to actually ordered 3 more that I'm going to be selling. So hit me up if you want a Supreme sweatshirt. I ordered 2 size medium and 1 size large, the same color, the black ones. That's about it. And can't think of anything else besides thank you for Sports Heat and Infinite Kicks for inspiring me to do more videos. I just want to give you a huge thanks. I can't say it more, but you guys have really inspired me to do YouTube, just to see how much you've guys grown up to like 400. Infinite Kicks, you're almost at like 500 subs. That's pretty insane to think that. I don't know how old you are. I think you're probably like 12 or something like that. I'm sorry if I like saying you look too young or something, but that's pretty cool to be like 12 years old and have almost 500 subs. I don't know what to say. That's just really cool. But yeah, this is Kick Central. Please like and subscribe and comment what kind of videos you want me to see to do over this winter break, and I'm out.